Today I'm going to give you a lecture on eigenvectors and Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Lecture number 9, eigenvectors and Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Now we discuss the problems related to eigenvectors. Question 1, find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the following matrix A. In order to determine eigenvector, first of all we find the eigenvalue of the square matrix A, and in order to get eigenvalues, very first we find the characteristic matrix of this square matrix A. Thereafter we find the characteristic polynomial using determinant, and finally characteristic equation. And the roots of that characteristic equation gives us eigenvalues for the given square matrix A, and corresponding to each eigenvalue we calculate eigenvectors. So let us start with square matrix A, which is of 3 to 3 order square matrix. Very first we construct the characteristic matrix of the given square matrix A, and according to the order of this square matrix A, because it is 3 into 3, so we consider a unique matrix or an identity matrix of similar order. Let us consider I, which is an identity matrix of 3 into 3 order, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. This is again 3 into 3 square matrix, and it is an identity matrix, or sometimes it is known as unit matrix, whose principal diagonal elements are 1, 1, and all remaining elements are 0. Now we multiply a scalar quantity lambda with the identity matrix I. So finally we get lambda 0, 0, 0, lambda into 1, lambda 0, 0, 0, and again lambda into 1. This is matrix lambda I, which is a scalar multiple of unit matrix I, where lambda is a scalar quantity. Now we subtract this lambda I from a given square matrix, A minus lambda I. This A minus lambda I is known as a characteristic matrix of the given square matrix A, which we obtain by just subtracting square matrix 8, minus 6, 2, minus 6, 7, minus 4, 2, minus 4, and 3, minus lambda 0, 0, 0, lambda 0, and 0, 0, lambda, and which gives us, in order to subtract these two square matrix, we simply subtract their corresponding elements. So 8 minus lambda, the first entry, remaining minus 6 in minus 6, minus 0, minus 6, 2 minus 0 gives us 2. Further, minus of 6, 7 minus lambda, and minus 4 minus 0 gives us minus 4. And again, 2 minus 0, 2, minus 4 minus 0, minus 4, and finally 3 minus lambda. And this is known as characteristic matrix. Characteristic matrix of given square matrix A. This resulting matrix is known as characteristic matrix of square matrix A. Further, we find the characteristic polynomial. And in order to find characteristic polynomial, we simply replace the square bracket with two vertical lines which represent the determinant value of this characteristic matrix. So characteristic polynomial is given by determinant of 8 minus lambda, minus of 6, 2, minus 6, 7 minus lambda, minus 4, 2, minus of 4 and 3 minus lambda. Now we expand this 3 into 3 determinant with the usual method. The expansion of this determinant is 8 minus lambda. We just write the first row and first column and cross multiply the entries, means 7 minus lambda multiply with 3 minus lambda, and minus 4 into minus 4 gives us plus 16, but we use negative sign between them, so this is minus of 16. Further we choose minus of 6, and because the second entry is always negative, so minus and minus gives us plus 6. And this time we hide the first row and second column, so we just cross multiply minus of 6 with 3 minus lambda, and my 4 to minus 4 into 2 gives us minus of 8 and minus of plus 8. And the third entry is plus 2. So we hide the first row and third column. Again we cross multiply, 6 4s are minus 6 into minus 4 gives us plus 24, and minus of twice 7 minus lambda. Further we expand this determinant 8 minus lambda. We simplify the linear factors, which is 7 minus lambda into 3 minus lambda. So 7 3s are 21, minus 7 lambda, minus of 3 lambda, and plus lambda square, and minus 16. Further we have plus 6. Minus 6 into 3 gives us minus of 18, and plus 6 lambda, and plus 8. Further, we have plus 2. Simplify this bracketed value, 24 minus 7 2s are 14, minus and minus gives us plus, so twice of lambda. Now, finally, we simplify the bracket, square bracket quantities, means lambda square. 7 and 3 gives us minus of 10 lambda. And 21 minus 16 gives us plus 5. Further, plus 6. Minus 18 plus 8 gives us 6 lambda minus of 10. And 24 minus 14 gives us 10, and this is 10 plus 2 lambda. On further simplification, we'll get 8 lambda square minus 80 lambda, the 5s are 40, minus lambda cube plus 10 lambda square and minus of 5 lambda. Further, we have 36 lambda minus 60 plus 20 plus 4 lambda. And finally, we simplify this expression, which is expansion of this 3 into 3 determinant value. And this, when we simplify the expression, when minus of lambda cube, further 10 and 8 gives us 18 lambda square. 18 lambda square. And after simplification, we find a minus of 45, because this minus 60 and plus 40. So these are the cancel out, these constant values are cancel out. 40 plus 20 gives us 60, minus 60 gives us 0. And finally, we have plus 36 and 4 as a 40. And this is minus of 85 lambda. So remaining is 45 lambda. This is the final cubic in terms of lambda after expanding this polynomial determinant value. So Now, in order to find the characteristic equation of a given square matrix A, we put this characteristic polynomial, which is minus of lambda cube plus 18 lambda square minus 45 lambda is equal to 0. This characteristic polynomial, when we put this characteristic polynomial is equal to 0, is our desired characteristic equation. And this equation can also be written like lambda cube minus 18 lambda square plus 45 lambda equal to 0. After simplifying, we get this limit equation in terms of lambda, and this is known as characteristic equation, which is characteristic equation of given square matrix. And roots of these characteristic equations are known as eigenvalues. So in order to obtain roots of this cubic equation in terms of lambda, we simplify this equation. If we choose lambda throughout common, we will observe lambda square minus 18 lambda plus 45. If we choose lambda as common throughout all three terms, we have two linear factor of this quadratic expression. If we factorize this quadratic expression in terms of lambda into two linear factor, clearly 15 threes are 45, so we write 15 lambda minus of 3 lambda plus 45. So one eigenvalue is clearly lambda equal to 0. And the remaining two eigenvalues we obtain by factorizing this. We choose lambda as a common. So lambda minus 15 and minus of 3 lambda minus 15, which gives us lambda minus 3 and lambda minus 15 as a two linear factor. And finally we get 3 and 15 as the remaining eigenvalues. So here this cubic equation possesses three roots of lambda. One is clearly 0. And the remaining two we find by factorizing this quadratic expression, and finally we get lambda equal to 3 and 15. So in totality we have three eigenvalues, lambda 1 which is 0, and the second eigenvalue is lambda 2 which is 3, and the third eigenvalue is lambda 3 which is 15. So these are the three eigenvalues of our given square matrix A, and we know that corresponding to each eigenvalue there exists an eigenvector. So now we compute the eigenvectors for each eigenvalue separately. So let us consider there arises three cases. Case 1, when eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to 0. Let us consider first eigenvalue as first eigenvalue 0 as lambda 1. And suppose capital X1 be the desired eigenvector for eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to 0. So here we consider capital X1. This capital X1 represents the eigenvector corresponding to eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to 0. And this eigenvector X1 is a column matrix which consists of three entries, X1, X2 and X3. Because our given square matrix A is of 3 into 3 elements, that's why we consider our eigenvector as a column matrix with three entries. If our square matrix A is of 2 into 2 order, then we consider our eigenvector x1 as just x1, x2 instead of x1, x2, x3. Further, as we know that Ax is equal to lambda x. This is universal. Ax is equal to lambda x, where A is our given square matrix. This capital X1 is a column matrix which consists of X1, X2, X3. this lambda is an eigenvalue. So particularly in case 1, we replace this capital X with X1 as a first eigenvector, and lambda with lambda 1, which is 0, our first eigenvalue is 0. Instead of A, we have a square matrix, which is (8, -6, 2, -6, 7, -4, 2, -4, and 3). For A, we have a square matrix of 8 to 3 order, which is given. For x1, we have x1, x2, and x3. This is the column matrix with 3 rows and 1 column is equal to lambda 1. In our case, our lambda 1 is 0. Again, we have column matrix x1, x2, x3, which is our eigenvector, unknown eigenvector, which has to be determined. Now we construct the equations with the help of product of these two matrices. So 8x1 minus of 6x2 plus twice of x3 is equal to 0 times of x1, which gives us 0, minus of 6x1 plus 7 times of x2 minus 4 times of x3 is equal to 0 into x2, which is again 0. Twice of x1 minus 4 times of x2 and twice of x3 and 0 into x3 again produce 0. So this system of equations are homogeneous because its right hand side is 0. And using any two equations among three equations, we can easily compute our desired entries for eigenvector, which is x1, x2, and x3. So let us consider the first two equations. Taking first two equations, x1, negative of x2, and x3. When we write the value in the denominator of x1, we hide the first column related to these two equations. So we hide this column and we write all the entries. Minus 6, 7, which are the coefficient of x2 in both the equation, and 2 and minus 4. For x2, we hide the second column and write the entries 8, minus 6, 2 and minus 4. And in order to calculate x3, we hide the third column and we write 8, minus 6, minus 6, and 7. Inside the determinant. Now we compute all the entries. First, multiply minus 6 with minus 4 gives us plus 24. Minus 7 to the 14. Minus of x2. 8 4s are minus of 32 and 6 2s are 12, minus and minus, this is plus 12. And x3, 8 7s are 56, minus 6 into minus 6 gives us plus 36, but we put negative sign between them, so finally we get 56 minus 36. This is the notation of determining, right? This is not a modulus value. So if we get a negative entry inside this, we put the value as such, because this is not modulus, this is determinant value. So 24 minus 14 gives us 10. This minus 32 plus 12 gives us minus of 20. But minus of 20 when multiplied with negative sign gives us 20. So we get 20. And in the third entry, again, 56 minus 36 again gives us 20. Now after simplifying the ratios, we will find x1 upon 1, x2 upon 2, and x3 upon 2. And these are the desired entries of our eigenvector x1, which is eigenvector corresponding to eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to 0. So our x1 will be x1, x2, x3 become 1, 2 and 2. So this is the desired eigenvector 1, 2, 2 corresponding to our eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to 0. In a similar manner, we determine the eigenvector corresponding to second eigenvalue, which is lambda equal to 3. So now we discuss the case for case second, when the eigenvalue lambda 2 is equal to 3. Suppose capital X2 with the eigenvector corresponding to eigenvalue lambda 2 equal to 3. Again, we construct the same Ax is equal to lambda x equation, and in this equation we replace our x with x2 and lambda with lambda 2, because our eigenvalue is second eigenvalue, lambda 2 is equal to 3, and our desired eigenvector is x2 in this case. So instead of this lambda 2 we have 3, so this time we put 3, otherwise the whole system remains same, our square matrix A remains same. This x2 which we assume eigenvector x2 is again x1, x2 and x3. So instead of capital X2, we have same x1, x2, x3 which are unknown to us and which has to be determined. Now again we construct the system of equations with the help of product of these matrices. So 8x1 minus of 6x2 plus twice of x3 is equal to, this time we have eigenvalue 3. Previously we have 0, so 0 multiplied with x1 gives us 0, but here we have 3 into x1, so it gives us thrice of x1. The next equation is minus of 6x1 plus 7x2 minus of 4x3 is equal to thrice time of x2. Now if you can see third equation, multiply 2 with x1, minus of 4 time of x2 plus 3 time of x3 is equal to thrice of x3. This is our new system of equations for case 2. Now further we simplify the equations, because on right hand side instead of 0 we have 3x1, 3x2 and 3x3. So accordingly we modify our equation. In first equation we will find on left hand side we have 8x1, while on right hand side we have thrice of x1. So we simply subtract 3x1 from 8x1. So remaining is 5x1 minus 6x2 plus thrice of x3 is equal to 0. We transfer this 3x1 towards the left hand side and we subtract from 8x1, and we get this equation 5x1 minus 6x2 plus twice of x3 equal to 0. Similarly, we modify our second and third equations. So we transfer 3x1 to the left hand side. So the 6x1 and minus of 6x1 remains as such. Out of 7x2, we subtract 3x2. So remaining is 4x2 minus 4x3 is equal to 0. In third equation, twice of x1 minus of 4 times of x2, thrice of x3 minus thrice of x3 gives us 0. So this is a 0 time of x3. So this is our desired system of equations which we obtain by multiplying the matrices. Again we consider any two equations. We may choose first two or last two, or we may choose first and third equation also in order to determine all unknown values of x1, x2, x3. So again we consider the first two equations. Taking first two equations. These two equations we consider, first two equations, and we write the value for denominator of x1, we have determinant of, we just write the first column of these two equations and we write minus of 6, 4, 2 and minus 4, the remaining coefficients of equation. For x2 we have negative sign, x2. In order to write the value in the denominator of x2, we just write the second column and write the values of 5, minus 6 and 2 and minus 4 for x2. And for x3, we write the third column and we put the value 5, minus of 6, minus 6 and 4. And finally, we simplify the denominator expression by just cross multiplying them. So, for x1, we get minus 6 into minus 4 gives us plus 24. 4 to the 8. Further, 5 4 is 20, which is minus of 20, and 6 2 is 12, but this negative and negative become positive, so gives us plus 12. And for x3, we cross multiply 5 4 is 20, and this minus 6 into minus 6 gives us plus 36, and plus 36 we subtract from this. So, after simplification, this is 16, this is again minus of 8, but minus minus become plus. Here 20 and minus of 36, so again we get minus of 16. And after simplification, these ratios are simplified, 8 to the 16 and 8 to the 16. So 2, 1 and minus 2. These are the three eigen values entries, second eigenvectors entries. So our desired eigenvector x2, for the eigenvalue lambda equal to 3, we have 2, 1 and minus 2. This is the desired second eigenvector corresponding to our eigenvalue lambda equal to 3. Similarly, we discussed the third case in which we determine the eigenvector for the eigenvalue lambda equal to 15. So in this manner we find the eigenvectors corresponding to given eigenvalues. Lambda equal to 0, 3 and 15, which we determine as an eigenvalue. And this is first eigenvector 1, 2, 2, which we obtain for the eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to 0. And in case 2, we find the eigenvector corresponding to eigenvalue lambda 2 equal to 3, which is 2, 1 and minus 2. And similarly, we discuss the case 3. In case 3, our third eigenvalue lambda 3 is equal to 15. So let us assume the eigenvector x3 corresponding to this eigenvalue lambda 3 is equal to 15. And we consider the system Ax3 is equal to lambda 3x3. And these are the values of square matrix A. And for x3, we have again x1, x2, x3. And 15 time of x1, x2, x3. We just simply replace our lambda 3 with 15. And we construct our equations, and finally we get minus of 7x1 minus 6x2 plus twice of x3 equal to 0. And second equation, third equation, whose right hand side is 0, because we modify our equations, we subtract 15x1 from 8x1, we subtract 15x2 from 7x2, we subtract 15x3 from 3x3, and finally we get this system of equations, three equations. And taking first two equations, again we proceed in a similar manner. For x1 we have this value for x2 and x3, and after cross multiplying them, we find the values which we get 14 minus of 40 and 20. And after simplifying this ratios, we will get x1 equal to 2 and x2 equal to minus of 2 and x3 equal to 1. So this is the third eigenvector corresponding to our eigenvalue lambda 3 equal to 15. So in this manner, we determine eigenvectors corresponding to each eigenvalue. So there is one more problem which is related to eigenvalues and eigenvector. Here our square matrix A is again 3 into 3 order. We construct its characteristic polynomial and then characteristic equation by putting characteristic polynomial equal to 0. And finally we get a characteristic equation which is lambda cube minus 7 lambda square plus 36 equal to 0, which produce 3 eigenvalues, minus of 2, 3 and 6. And for each eigenvalue, as we proceed in the previous problem, we will find eigenvector corresponding to first eigenvalue lambda 1 equal to minus 2, which is the capital X1. This is the first eigenvector corresponding to eigenvalue minus of 2, which is 1, 0, minus 1. For lambda 2 equal to 3, we will find x2, which is the second eigenvector, 1, minus 1 and 1 for lambda 2 equal to 3. For lambda 3 equal to 6 eigenvalue, we construct our third eigenvector x3, which is 1 to 1. Now we discuss the Cayley-Hamilton theorem. See, according to the statement of Cayley-Hamilton theorem, every square matrix always satisfies its own characteristic equation. Means, suppose we have some square matrix, first of all, find its characteristic matrix, then get its characteristic polynomial, and then we construct its characteristic equation, which we obtain in terms of lambda. So, according to this theorem, that equation, characteristic equation, is always satisfied by its given square matrix. This is the statement of Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Every square matrix always satisfies its own characteristic equation. So let us consider a matrix A, which is a square matrix and whose characteristic equation is clearly determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. That is, n degree equation in terms of lambda, because here we consider our square matrix A is of n into n order. That's why we get an equation in terms of lambda of n degree. If you consider a square matrix of 2 into 2 order, definitely you get a quadratic expression in terms of lambda. If we have a square matrix of 3 into 3 order, then clearly our equation will be cubic polynomial in terms of lambda. So then according to this Cayley-Hamilton theorem, this A square matrix always satisfies its characteristic equation. Means instead of lambda, if you write A and simplify the powers of A, A to the power n minus 1 and so on, finally we get 0. Means every square matrix always satisfies its own characteristic equation. Okay, in order to verify this statement, Cayley-Hamilton theorem, there is a matrix A, which is a 2 into 2 square matrix. This 2 into 2 square matrix. First, we verify this Cayley-Hamilton theorem for this square matrix. And in order to verify Cayley-Hamilton theorem, first of all, we find the characteristic matrix of this given square matrix A. So, here our A is 2, 3, minus 1 and 2. Now we determine the characteristic matrix for this square matrix A, which is of 2 into 2 order. According to the order of K, we consider the unit matrix I, which is again 2 into 2 order, 1, 0, 0, 1, is again 2 into 2 order. Multiply this unit matrix I with a scalar quantity lambda, so we get lambda 0, 0, lambda. And in order to obtain characteristic matrix of A, characteristic matrix of A, we subtract lambda I from given square matrix A. So this is 2, 3, minus 1 and 2. We subtract lambda 0, 0 lambda. And finally, we subtract the corresponding element in order to subtract these two matrices. So 2 minus lambda, 3 minus 0 versus 3, minus of 1 and 2 minus lambda. So this is our desired characteristic matrix of given square matrix A of 2 into 2 order. Now we determine the characteristic polynomial. Characteristic polynomial. For characteristic polynomial, we simply replace the square bracket with two vertical lines which represent the determinant value of this characteristic matrix. And after expanding this 2 into 2 determinant, we get the desired characteristic polynomial, and which is 2 minus lambda multiplied with 2 minus lambda. Minus of 3 and minus this is plus 3. Finally, 4 minus of 4 lambda plus lambda square plus 3. And which gives us lambda square minus of 4 lambda, 4 plus 3 gives us 7. So this is lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 7 is our characteristic polynomial for the square matrix A. Now, as soon as we put this characteristic polynomial is equal to 0, it gives us our desired characteristic equation. So now we find the characteristic equation by letting determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0. Lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 7 is equal to 0. This is characteristic equation, which is characteristic equation . Now, in order to verify Kelly-Meriton theorem, we simply replace lambda with A, because this is the statement of Kelly-Meriton theorem that every square matrix always satisfies its own characteristic equation. So, in order to verify Kelly-Meriton theorem, instead of lambda we write A. So it gives us A square minus of 4 times of A plus 7 equal to 0. So we start with the left hand side. We start with left hand side A square minus of 4 times of A plus 7. And finally, if we get 0, then Kelly-Meriton theorem become verified. So how we find the A square? We simply multiply A twice time, means A into A. This is 2, 3, minus 1 into 2. Now, multiply these two square matrices, same matrices, A into A. 2, 3, minus 1 into 2. Again, 2, 3 and minus 1 into 2. Multiply this column with 2. With minus of 1, 3 and 2 and finally add 2. So 2 2's are 4, 4 minus of 3 gives us 1, minus 2 and minus 2 gives us minus of 4, 3 2's are 6 and 6 gives us 12. And minus 3 and plus 4 gives us 1. So this is our A square. Now we put the value of A square here. Multiply our given square matrix A with 4. And instead of writing 7, we write 7i. Because I represent the unit matrix. And we'll find, after simplifying the left hand side, we get the desired value 0, which shows that Kelly-Meriton theorem verified for this square matrix A. So this is characteristic polynomial which we already solved on the board, lambda square minus of 4 lambda plus 7 equal to 0, which is our characteristic equation. And in order to verify Kelly-Meriton theorem, we start with A square, which we get 1 minus 4, 12 and 1. Right? Now, further, we substitute the value of A square, which we obtain 1, 12, minus 4 and 1. For A, we have square matrix 2, 3, minus 1 and 2. And instead of 7, we write 7i. So 7 into unit matrix of 2 into 2 order 1, 0, 0, 1. And after simplifying this expression, we'll observe 0,0,0,0, which shows Hans Kelly-Hamilton theorem satisfied. Now, by using the same Kelly-Hamilton theorem, the second part of our question is find the A inverse. See, previously we find the inverse of any square matrix by a traditional method, which is inverse of any matrix A is given by adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. This is the traditional method for finding inverse of any matrix A. But here is one of the application of Kelly-Hamilton theorem is to find the inverse of any matrix without using this traditional formula. With the help of this Kelly-Hamilton theorem, we can easily find our A inverse. So how we proceed here? According to Kelly-Hamilton theorem, clearly A square minus 4 times of A plus 7i gives us 0. So we write A square minus 4 times of A plus 7i is equal to 0. In order to find A inverse, we simply pre-multiply with A inverse on both sides of the equation. So A inverse into A square, 4 times of A inverse A plus A inverse I, and A inverse into 0 gives us 0. On right hand side, we also multiply with A inverse because the 0 matrix, so primes. A inverse in A square gives us A, 4 times of I, and when we multiply any matrix with the unit matrix, it reflects the same matrix. So A inverse into I gives us A inverse. Now, for 7 A inverse, we shift 4i towards the right hand side, so it gives us plus of 4i instead of minus 4i. This A becomes negative, minus of A. As soon as we transfer towards the right hand side, A becomes minus of A, minus 4i becomes plus 4i. And finally, for 7 time of A inverse is given by 4 time of I, which is 1,0,0,1. And our matrix A is 2,3, minus 1 and 2. So multiply scalar 4 with matrix and subtract from this 2,3, minus 1 and 2. And finally, we observe 2,1, minus 3 and 2. This is the desired 7 A inverse. Right? This is the value of 7 A inverse. From here, we can easily find our A inverse value, which is 2 by 7, minus 3 by 7, 1 by 7, and 2 by 7. Because we transfer this 7 towards the right hand side, the denominator. So in this manner, we find our A inverse without using a traditional formula which we used previously for finding A inverse. So this is one of the application of Kelly-Hamilton theorem for finding A inverse. So this is another problem. Verify Kelly-Hamilton theorem for the matrix A. Find its inverse. So this problem is almost same which we discussed previously. In the previous problem, we have matrix A of 2 into 2 order. Here we have, instead of 2 into 2, we have 3 into 3 square matrix, for which we have to verify Kelly-Hamilton theorem and we find its inverse. So first of all, we construct our characteristic equation in a usual manner. First, we find our characteristic polynomial, that is determinant A minus lambda I. And as soon as we put its characteristic polynomial equal to 0, it gives us our desired characteristic equation, which is a cubic equation in terms of lambda because A is of 3 into 3 order. So lambda cube minus 6 lambda square plus 9 lambda minus 4 equal to 0. In order to verify this Kelly-Hamilton theorem, we replace lambda with A. So instead of lambda cube, we have A cube minus of 6 lambda square, we have minus of 6 A square plus 9 lambda become plus 9 times of A minus of 4i equal to 0. So we first find our A cube or A square. In order to find A square, we simply multiply square matrix A with A itself. And then in order to find A cube, we again multiply one more time A square with A. So we get the A cube. And whatever expression we get for A cube, we put the value of A cube instead of A cube. And for A square and A, we have already in our given square matrix. And I is the unit matrix of similarly 3 into 3 order unit matrix. And we simplify this expression So this is the a square value, which you can easily find by multiplying a with a, similarly a cube. And finally, we assign a cube, 6a square, 9a and 4i, and we'll observe that the resulting matrix become vanished 0, 0, 0. And this shows Kalman-Hilton theorem verified. And in order to find inverse of a, we simply pre-multiply with a inverse on both sides of the equation, because right hand side is already 0, so our right hand side again vanished. And the a square becomes a, this a and a inverse gives us I, and time time of a and a inverse is equal to 0. And finally we get a inverse equal to 1/4 of 3, 1, minus 1, 1, 3, 1, and minus 1, 1, and 3. So in this manner, we verify our Kalman-Hilton theorem and find the inverse of any given square matrix. Right? Thank you.